This video is brought to you by Squarespace. On this video, we're gonna see how we can create the hologram effect very easily in Final Cut Pro 10 and how we can make some adjustments and changes on that effect from a plugin that I made in Motion, and I'm giving it away for free to you so you don't have to create it in Motion. So, let's start. We're in the Final Cut Pro 10 interface, and as you can see, I have placed two clips. The first clip is me that is, pretending to do the scrolling on the hologram effect, and on top, you'll see a screen recording of my phone while I'm scrolling on YouTube. So the first thing that we want to do is to go into the effects. I assume you have already downloaded the free effect, the hologram effect. You will drag this and place it into the recording of your phone. You can try it without the recording of your phone, but this is the easier for me process to showcase the effect as I'm showing, for example, from your phone to have a hologram. But of course, this will work with any footage that you have and you want to showcase as a hologram, for example, yourself or any other your imagination can create. So now we will go on the right and we see on the inspector panel the effects of the hologram. What gives us the hologram that you downloaded is that we can have rotation on the X, Y, and Z axis. This is very important, so we can have the different rotations that we're gonna need, and also we can change the scale, the position, and I have now these options here. For example, hologram glow. As I'm activating this, you see that I can control the amount of the glow, and from here I can control the tint as well. Okay, so for example, this is very Kian teal, okay, but I can send the tint to 0.7, for example, it will be more white, and I can control the color. If I click here, I can control the glint size, okay, as you can see here, the streaks, and all the other settings like the softness, the amount, the angle. As you can see here, I can control the angle, the intensity, the color fringing. And from here, I have the mix, okay, that I can change everything. Now, also, I have included the bud scan effect. As you can see, this is without the bud scan effect. This is with the bud scan effect. And why we need that? Because usually in holograms, there is some kind of glitch effect inside. So I gathered all of that into one effect. And again, I'm telling you, I'm giving that for free. But all of these are things that you can create in Apple Motion. If you don't have the Apple Motion, then this is for you. Of course, we can change other parameters here, like the roll, the static, and all the other stuff about the glitch effect, okay, the bud scan effect. So what do we do now? The first thing that we want to do is to control where we're gonna place the hologram. So I'm gonna change the Y rotation, as you can see here, to make it look more to me. Okay, I'm gonna reverse it, and then I can change the scale, okay, and the X rotation, so I can make it more to my hand, okay? Let's go around here. Wonderful. Next step, I'm going to the opacity, and I'm gonna change the opacity for this footage for about 15%. Now, you can change it to whatever you want the most, okay? So, you can control that where you want it. For me, it's going to be around 15%. And then I'm going to go to transform, click here and select it and place it above, you know, above the phone that it's going to be. Now, I'm going to move a little bit on the footage to see where my hand is, okay? So I can match this, okay? So let's bring it a little bit more to the left. Let me change the scale a little bit. Okay, and also I can change the X rotation a little bit here. And more to the left. Simply as that, as you see right now, let's go and play. You see that the hologram all ready is working. And let's go now and see how we can make the introduction. Okay, so here I'm clicking on that. Let me bring it here a little bit and also change the scale again. Okay. How we're gonna bring it by small to big, okay? What are we gonna do? Let's go where I click the button. All right. And I will go into the transform. I will add a keyframe to position, a keyframe to scale all, and a keyframe to anchor. And I will go where I want it to start the appearance when I click the button. Here. Okay. Let me talk a little bit about Squarespace. If you don't know who Squarespace is an online platform where you can get your domain or build your own website. And the best thing about Squarespace is that you don't have to know anything about web design or web developing. With Squarespace, you choose a template from high-end designers' templates that you can choose, and you will use it as your structure to start building your website. Simple as that. So if you are a videographer, YouTuber, creative artist, and, you know, having a website is a must. Head over to squarespace.com/Emilio. If you don't have a website and want to create one, you can try it for free first. And when you're ready to buy, you can use the coupon code Emilio and get 10% off your first purchase of a website or domain. Let's go back into the video. And I'm gonna make the scale all a little bit smaller. I'm gonna drag here and place it where I want it to start, okay? So I can have the position, and then make it all to 0%. So if I play right now, let's see the result. And to make it even more better, when we have the beginning of the animation, I will grab the motion blur effect. You will see a link of the plugin, the motion blur plugin, the description of this video down below. And I will go into the frames to see where I want it to be until here, the motion blur. Okay, I will select this and blade it and delete it. I don't want the zoom blur on the motion blur. You will also find a link for the free version of the motion blur that it will work just fine for that purpose. And with the motion blur is gonna look like this, but we want something else to make it complete, okay? And I'm not talking about the sound effects and the sound design, which also is very important. You might need to track it when your phone is moving, as you see right here. So what we're gonna do is when we have it open, okay, here, you can either go into the position, okay, and add again a keyframe and change it on the position where it is, okay? So for example, I can add a keyframe here and go frame by frame. Let me select that. I can change it a little bit to the right. Now it moved a little bit on top, frame by frame with the right again. Can move it a little bit. I'm following, as you see, the movement here of my hand. If I zoom in a little bit, let's see here. I'm following with that. Again, a little bit to the right. So we can create some of the movement. And as soon as I finish with that, you will see that the final result, and it's gonna look like this. We have the tracking as well. Of course, you can use third-party plugins that you can track your subject. It's gonna work just like fine. And then simply when I'm clicking on that, I'm transitioning to the next clip, the clip that we want to appear after the click. Of course, you can go, for example, you can go here, okay? Let's say that you had the movement that you're moving it away, okay? So what I would do is to go into the transform, add a keyframe to position, and at the end of it, select that, and for the position, get it away. So it would be like, whoo, get out of here, okay? If you had the hand. And that was it. Simple as that.
I hope you found this video helpful and you learned how to create holograms. And if you enjoyed this video, like it. Also, I'm waiting to read your comments in the comment section down below. If you have any suggestions for other tutorials or plugins in the future, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel and ring the notification bell to be the first to receive notifications whenever I post a new video. Thank you so much for watching. I'm Emilio Takas, and I will see you in the next video.